We continue with our talk about how to maintain health and how to improve health. Not through any magical pills, etc., but by total lifestyle modifications. And in that, the most recent scientific approach is what we also can call holistic approach of hormesis, where a low level of stress of choice, the stress coming either from physical activity, from temperature, from mental engagement, exercise of the brain, or from food components, either not eating food for a short while, for one day per week kind of stuff, or taking spices and all that, why they give you benefit. So I have been sharing with you the basic scientific principles behind why those kind of mild stresses, which have to be repeated again and again, like exercise is not going to give you all the benefits in one bout. You have to do it. And then you start seeing the things. Same thing about the food thing. So what science has so far come to understand in the science of health and science of healthy aging, there are basically three factors which help us maintain health and which may help us to live longer and better, but we cannot promise that right by doing things now. If I maintain health, yes, it will help me, but there are millions of other factors which can intervene, but we'll come to that later on. So food, physical activity, and social and mental engagement. These are the three powerful pillars of health. They all need to be strengthened again and again to maintain health. I will give you one example from food, that how to use the principles of hormesis in food, which can give some help towards maintaining health. We always talk about good food and bad food. Oh, this food is bad, this food is good. There is no such thing. There is no food which is bad. There is no food which is good. These are the consequences of taking food which can lead to good or bad effects. You cannot pinpoint on any individual this fat or this protein or this kind of sugar is absolutely bad all the time. No, it is again the dose. How much you take? When do you take? That is going to determine. I can kill myself by drinking water all the time too much. That is the biggest killer. But without water, I can't live either. Yeah. So how do we choose which food is good and bad? The research is mostly done. We talk about nutrition. Nutrition means protein, carbohydrate, fats, micronutrients, vitamins, etc. But first of all, nobody eats nutrition. Remember that. I did not eat nutrition this morning. I eat some kind of food. And it's not even food which I eat. I eat either a meal. Yeah? Like if you tell me or I tell you that I ate chicken today. Now you might think some image of chicken in your mind. I might have eaten very spicy Indian curry. But you might be imagining it's a simple roasted chicken with nothing. Yeah, a little bit of salt and pepper. So we don't eat nutrition, we eat food. Food can be plant-based or animal-based. So that's first distinction. But animal-based plant and food-based plant is determined what way we prepare it. And that is a strong cultural factor. What food we eat is the same ingredients, but different cultures will have different food combinations. When you offer me chicken, I am salivating, thinking it's a tandoori chicken with a lot of spices. And if it's not, that food is not actually appealing to me. So talking about food without involving the cultural aspect is not a good thing. A lot of science does that, as if you can measure things in a chemical formula. You can put nutrients in the pills and you can have it. But no, it doesn't work. So, and then the next step of the food, from nutrition to food, is actually meal. We take breakfast, we take lunch, we take dinner. And what makes meal is also our social interaction with who, in whose company we eat it. You can give me a fantastic, healthy, scientifically calculated meal and I'm sitting alone and miserable. That is not going to perhaps help me. Meal taken in the context of society. So first step of what food is going to be good for you is food must give you pleasure. If food does not give you pleasure, it's not going to be good. Because food is not drug that you can take it even if it's bitter and everything and it's going to do wonders. Food must give you pleasure. Somehow, scientists have reduced the importance of pleasure. But now we realize that actually pleasure is the first starting point. But that's also a little bit controversial, because pleasure means what? When I eat a very heavy, fatty McDonald's burger, of course it gives me great pleasure. Yeah, but then the difference is that within few minutes, or I start beating myself, feeling guilty. Yeah, because we all know what kind of things are harming us over long term. So the pleasure is the pleasure which does not make you feel guilty for at least 3 days. That's our a little funny kind of thing, but we are trying to do research also on that. Which does not make you feel guilty. You eat the food which gives you pleasure, but you don't feel guilty about that food for a longer time. That means that food is on the right track for your system. Individualizing. Never, never estimate the importance of pleasure in food. If I am given all this greenery, salads for my health part and I hate it, it's not going to do anything to me in overall, yeah, a sense. So food needs to be taken in pleasure. The second part of the food from hormetic point of view is it has to be taken in moderation. A pleasure-giving food cannot be taken so much that it becomes a painful experience. Now, moderation is not easy to measure. What moderation? Sometime in science we say 40% less calories, 50, but it doesn't work. Moderation basically means that you never finish your meal with a totally swollen feeling that you can't do anything and you can't even walk. Just 5-10% less than what you can actually eat, but leave the last little bit of bread there. Yeah, so that kind of stuff, that wasting a little bit of food than wasting the body, is perhaps a good idea. But individual variation will be there. But remember, moderation is a very, very important. Pleasure, moderation. Third factor is even more important from hormesis point of view, variation. Yeah, just like exercise, physical exercise, even great athletes, they never do the same exercise every day or continuously. For every exercise to be beneficial, you have to give a recovery period during which you get benefits. Same thing about hormesis, other in the food hormesis. When I eat, say, spices, say, haldi or the turmeric, it needs to work in the body. But if I am eating it all the time, body stops using as a hormetin. So one has to vary the food. It should give pleasure, it should be taken in moderation, and it should be variable so that the body gets all the benefits out of it. Same principles apply even to terms of social and mental engagement. But we will talk about that a little bit more next time. See you then.